All right, folks, we are back, and we might not be back better than ever. The big man is hurting. He's down bad with the sickness. We got Mr. Vincent Pavilonis. Gentlemen, how are we doing?
Good. Could be better, but we'll get past it. I couldn't, your guys text today. I couldn't miss out on, you know, you guys bashing me another day. So I'm going to push through.
That's good. Oh, when I heard that little Bobby couldn't go to school today, I had all the ammunition ready to go. But, you know, I sent him that gift of Scottie Pippen and Michael Jordan, and he understood what that meant. So I'm glad that he is here with us this evening.
I mean, it's the flu game. I get it. I can't, especially after talking about Jordan the other day, the other podcast. I'm committed. So
I was just telling Vince, so to give the listeners some background here, at about 4 o'clock, Rob texted the group saying, hey, I might not make it tonight. I think I have COVID. I'm down bad. And then he just went dark for like 4 hours. And me and Vince were just ripping through the text saying basically like, hey, last week when I had COVID, I made it on the show. You know, some people just want it more than others. And then Vince's flu game GIF came in. And then we knew it was going to be a fireworks show tonight with us just probably ripping on the big man. And then the big man at about 8:05 sent the Undertaker GIF where he comes back to life out of the coffin, meaning that he was back on for tonight. So,
oh yeah,
it got the boys riled up. I told Vince, I was like, man, I was hurting. I was pretty tired. And I was like, you know, I really wasn't motivated. And then I saw that text and it got me fired up. Responded right back with the Wolf of Wall Street GIF. And yes, then the boys were buzzing. The boys were buzzing, and here we are. So
I mean the Wolf of Wall Street has to have the top like 5 GIFs out there. Anytime
for sure.
Anytime one of the boys sends it out, it gets you fired up. The other one I wanted to send was, remember how like the little Kool-Aid man used to come through the wall?
Yeah.
Yep.
That was my backup.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm a big fan of the guy, like, basically it's like an excuse me gif. It's like the guy who like blinks and he like looks off to that one I love. It's basically saying like, what are you talking about? Kind of thing, or like an oh really,
sure. Or when Alan's, you know, doing the math when he's doing the cards from the Hangover,
yes, and all the formulas are going,
yes,
around. Yeah.
Right. One of my favorite for schools, like anytime we have like something in our text string, I'll just put in Shaq, and usually there's something that'll come up that is Shaq wise that fits the situation. So try that one the next time.
Just a random gif of Shaq.
Yeah, like it'll be like him doing just like different stuff. Like he'll be mad in some. He's kind of like, in like another one there. It's just like whatever I need, I can just put in Shaq and I'll find something. But I also like, you know, sometimes, you know, we got like a bet going on or something. And it's the one little pudgy kid with like two like desserts. And he's like looking this way, looking that way, like not knowing which way to go.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a favorite for sure.
That's a good one.
Well, it's good to hear the boys are doing well. Did we catch any more of the Grant Thornton from last week? We'll recap a little bit. Jason Day, Lydia Ko won that. Did we catch the weekend of that, Big Rob or Vince?
Yeah, I thoroughly enjoyed it. I liked how they, I didn't realize they were going to do different formats. So, you know, Saturday let a lot of groups back in it. But yeah, Sunday was good to watch. Kind of was a little disappointed with Nelly and Tony, but I mean, to see Day win again, and Lydia Ko is awesome too. So it was good to see him, you know, how they won, and like how that, you know, he was more for her. I like the interview afterwards saying like he knew she had it in the bag, you know, teeing off an 18 and stuff like that. So it was cool for each tour to give credit to each other. And it was just all in all, an awesome tournament to watch. And like they said, they hope it happens for years to come. So I'm on board with that. Give me a couple more during the year and I'd love it too.
Yeah, it was definitely the most golf I have watched since like, I mean, the Ryder Cup, I watched that first morning, figured, well, this is going nowhere. So probably since the last major, pretty much most of Saturday, pretty much all of Sunday as well. I do like Jason Day. Old Bad Back Day, you know, it's good to see him back out there. And I agree, Robert. I do like the different formats. Maybe more on that later to come. But I kind of find myself always like, there's like some like Canadians in the mix, Brooke Henderson and Corey Connor. Mm-hmm. I found myself kind of cheering for them. And one of the reasons is like their fans always come out like middle of Florida. There's a bunch of Canadians there with flags and the red pants on and everything. And so I was kind of pulling for them a little bit. Corey Connors was one of my betting darlings when I first started, when the book's still open here in like Illinois, just because he was like kind of an unknown, and like his top 20 numbers were just like ridiculous. And he was like top 15 easily all the time. So it was great. I don't know if you guys caught it as well, but a lot of kids around the property walking around there. And my dad was watching it also. And he had mentioned like, a lot of females were in the crowd as well. I think maybe just like, you know, younger golfers and everything. So talking about growing the game, like getting people interested, like this was definitely the thing to have. So
it was, I mean, the scene on 18 was awesome when they were walking out, when they, you know, Lydia Cole got a louder cheer than Jason Day did. And same thing with Nelly, then Tony. It was just really cool to see that, you know, people are out there to support the whole situation. So,
yeah, I agree. I think the event was A plus all around. I think we touched a little bit about it last episode. Like the recipe isn't hard, and I don't know why it's taken this long to figure it out. Like, put out the best players in the world from both sides, and look what happens. Like, and to Rob's point, I didn't know the format changed either. I thought that was pretty cool. But also to your point, it was super cool to see, like, it almost seemed like the PGA Tour player were like more infatuated playing with the LPGA players. So that was super cool to see. Like, you could almost tell like they were like blown away seeing their games like in action, which is super cool. But yeah, I thought the event was awesome. And again, I would for sure watch something like that. Like, I think the timing was perfect too. You know, not to say like I wouldn't watch it during the full heavy swing of the PGA Tour, but I just think this is a great time. You know, there's a lot of downtime right now, especially with, you know, football, and just the scheduling was perfect, I thought. And then in other golf news, we got the PNC going. Today was the first practice round of the PNC. Yeah. Obviously, I'm sure Rob and Vince were thrilled to see all of the Tiger and Charlie action on Twitter. I'm sure you couldn't get enough of it. What do you guys think about that going on?
I mean, Big John and Little John are going to whoop them like Patton for a dance. I tell you that much right now. Sorry, I had to jump ahead of you there, Robert, but I was fired up about this one. Just seeing some of the pictures, I think it was from last night. John Daly's got his wild jacket on. Little John's got on a suit and tie, a razorback tie, and then little Charlie, he's got something nice on. But Tiger's got on this like just button up shirt, and if you look closely, he is like just drenched in sweat. So I don't know if he was like making the rounds or like what he was doing, but like Big John looked cool as can be with a big old bushy beard there, and Tiger's just got like beads of sweat on his head. His shirt is soaked through. So
yeah, I mean, detoxing probably.
Could be.
Yeah. No, I. You know what I got a kick out of talking about Daly is that, you know, he could sit there and bend and touch his toes. I was pretty impressed by that video today.
Super impressed.
But no, just to take from like Shockland's start, it was complete catnip today with Charlie and, you know, Tiger. But I don't know. It was cool to see. Like, I got a kick out of, I don't know why I laughed at it, but the whole point of throwing the chicken tender at Charlie during his interview. That was funny.
Yeah.
But I don't know. You knew they're going to be paired with Justin Thomas and his dad, but it's as a dad myself, it's cool to see stuff like that, you know, with the father son or, you know, the father daughter. I'm excited for it. It's nice that it's a Saturday Sunday. It's a good follow up to last weekend, I think, to be honest with you. And like we said the other week, it's, golf is good when Tiger's playing. So hopefully it might be Daly in the woods, you know, on Sunday. Who knows? But I'm excited for it.
So yeah. Now, Charlie, he is going a tee back this year now, right?
I don't know. Is he?
I think he is. I think last year he was at like a forward tee, but this year he's, I think, going back to the same tee box where like Little John would be and like all the other kids of like that age. I think there's one more and then the pros tee box. But did you see, I saw it on Twitter, of Charlie's like recoil.
I was just going to say,
probably about like 20 swings in a row and him just like swinging and like bringing it back with the recoil. Like, I probably watched it like four times in a row.
I wanted to say somebody should tell him, you know, 20 years from now, his back's going to be our situation, you know?
So. Right. Did you see the one hole? I think it was a short par four. It was like 380, but it was supposedly reported that his ball went like 320. He absolutely nuked one.
It doesn't surprise me with the equipment and all that stuff. Now, plus, you know, I like the comparisons of the, you know, years, and it looks like he's gotten bigger since last year, obviously.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, definitely.
But I got a kick out of when, I did get a kick out of when Tiger took the driver off the deck and Charlie was like, "What are you doing?" Basically, that was a good one too.
Yeah. He's like, "Are you kidding me?" But no, I figured you two would be losing your mind today, scrolling Twitter, just seeing nonstop Charlie and Tiger content. That was the first thing I thought about, to be honest. I'm like, they're gonna unleash.
I mean, you're right. I mean, my feed, every other post that I scrolled down was the same video retweeted. I mean, it is what it is. It's good for golf. So
right. Ryan French was getting a bit annoyed by it. Did you see some of his tweets? Basically he was saying, not so much annoyed by that, but basically he was saying the PGA Tour like was giving zero. I think he counted the tweets and it was like 8 tweets to Charlie and Tiger versus like 2 tweets about Q School. So he just wanted pretty much more recognition for Q School and kind of what's going on at final stage right now and so forth and so on. But and then again, he was like, I get it, but you know, this is a pretty important part of everyone's life, so forth and so on. Speaking of those guys, dude, did you see the weather forecast that they got for tomorrow and Sunday?
For the PNC?
No, for the
final stage.
Yeah.
No.
It's brutal, man. It's like 90% rain, wind gusts, like 30 mile an hour. Like it's not good.
Oh.
I think he's already said that like 7 people have already withdrawn just because of like there's no reason to stick around for that. That's just crazy to me, but yeah,
with Q School, wasn't like, then Wesley Bryan put up like a quadruple bogey today and still fire like a 60 whatever. It was a crazy, really?
Yeah,
it was nuts.
I think it's 66 with an 8 on like 7 or something like that. I think he 4 putted, absolutely bananas. And then in other golf news, we finally got a little bit of closure from Mr. Finau, saying, you know, again, we're going back to the Wolf of Wall Street gif. I'm not leaving. Mm-hmm. So it was nice. He kind of committed to the PGA Tour and put those rumors to bed. And then I also saw Victor Hovland today committed to like 7 or 8 tournaments. So that kind of puts those rumors to bed.
Mm-hmm.
But now it's like, okay, well, you know, who's left? And obviously you still have Xander, who's always been rumored, Cantlay, which I don't think is the case because he's on the player advisory, but who knows? Maybe he doesn't give a shit. But yeah, how about the news out of the Finau camp?
Yeah, I mean, I think that was awesome. Especially with going back to last week in the tournament, that kind of sucked that they came out on, what, Friday, Saturday, and you're still playing. And, you know, to deal with that bullshit, but I don't know why I get it, the money and everything like that, but I'm glad that he's staying, to be honest with you. And then you got Hatton that committed to Hawaii too, so maybe that rumor's not there anymore too. But I guess my other question is, you know, sure, these guys are committing to tournaments coming up, but what's also to stop them from still signing with LIV and just at the drop of a hat if the number's right? So that kind of sucks. That's a thought in the back of my head too.
That's very true.
So you think maybe this just cools all those all the talk? Possibly. I just feel like, you know, Tony's had like a really fascinating career where I think he had like basketball scholarships and he was
playing
mini tours, in Canada. He was on Big Break. He played, you know, the web.com and all these different things, and kind of like the long road to get to where he is. So maybe he just felt like, you know, I've always wanted to play on the PGA Tour. And, you know, when you're going through all these different tours, like playing Big Break, coming in second place there, like there are many times you're like, well, maybe I'll just go and, you know, do something else with my life so I can get like a constant paycheck. So I don't know if that would like play into it or not, but I've always wondered, like, has Jason Day been mentioned for Liv? Just like him and his bad back, like, the lesser schedule and three rounds may benefit him and just getting a bunch of money. And I have not heard much about him. I don't know if you guys have.
Yeah, I mean, the other thing too, I think about is, you know, what came out today about the, what is it, the U.S. sports team with the $3 billion injected in the PGA. Like, did Finau and them know about this last week, you know, too? Like, all this news coming up, maybe it's all finally coming into place. Maybe they're still looking for Pith to bring in another $3 billion. So what, because they value it at what, like $17 billion or something like that. So I don't know. I think there's a lot of moving parts, obviously, that we could all wrap our heads around and try to figure out, but it's a good thing that Tony's staying.
Right. And I, to your point, I think that's an interesting point. And again, it was referenced in that report as, and I don't know if I'm just looking too far into this, but again, the sports group, the Fenway Sports Group, was listed prior to the PIF, and it almost seems like the PGA Tour is like, the way that it's worded, it almost like comes off as like, yeah, the PIF is like our secondary option. You know, this new evolving sports group is, you know, kind of the front runner. Did you get that kind of vibe from reading it too?
Well, it's funny, like listening to like other podcasts, right? Shotgun Start, whoever, when they have their thoughts, and some of it's like kind of makes sense. Like maybe they want the sports group in because they don't want the PIF to feel like they have all the power, right? So if they're on the lower end of the deal, then PGA still has the control of everything, right? So, you know, I'm not sure. It's interesting to me that the PIF is, they were all right with PGA still like shopping around for other investment groups, you know?
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct. Yeah. I'm surprised by that too. I'm surprised they're like, listen, we don't want another partner. Like we could fund this entire thing.
Sure.
You know, we don't need them. Yeah. That's interesting too. No, what else is interesting is Vince's package that showed up today. Vince, why don't you tell the people what came in the mail today? And so
today,
what's that?
I got home here. Costco. Got the Costco irons. They came in the mail today. And they look sharp. I'll be honest, they look just like those TaylorMade's. But this is the pitching wedge right here. If you can see that, if you're on YouTube. If not, hop on YouTube and take a look.
I was going to say,
they're sharp.
For the listeners, he's doing a bit of an unboxing right now.
Unboxing here. But it's been a long time since I've had like brand new golf clubs. You got to, you know, take the tape off of the grips over here just because they're so expensive. I mean, it's probably $1,300 for those TaylorMade's, and like these were $500. And they're a little lighter than I thought that they were going to be, but still, you know, nothing like too light or anything. But yeah, I'm excited to get the plastic off of here and just hit it, compare them to my TaylorMade AP3s. They're the 718, so they're from 2018. Just to kind of compare them, I do plan on extending them 1 inch and then putting on some mid-size grips, what I'm used to. But I'm impressed, you know, like it doesn't feel flimsy in any way. And you know, I was kind of reading down the rabbit hole of Twitter and other places about, you know, how they're garbage, they're trash, it's Kirkland, it can't be any good. Hey, you go into Costco, you get a 4-pack of Kirkland pizzas for $8. You tell me those are not good pizzas. So the name on there doesn't matter. Like, we'll see. I want to hit onto the track man and see, okay, what does my 7-iron do compared to this one? And maybe I'll game them. Maybe I'll get a Kirkland golf bag going forward and, you know, a hot warmer for some hot dogs on the side of the cart. But no, they feel good.
So
what did that set run you?
$500.
And it's what, four through pitching wedge?
Four through pitching wedge, yes.
I must say, they do look pretty clean. And to be honest, yeah, they kind of remind me a lot of the first set of clubs that were ever built for me. And those were the Malpe blades. They look identical.
Okay.
Maybe because the color, too, because Malpe was a red. Yeah, I think they look good. I mean, the Kirkland signature is kind of large. Not signature, but like the block letter of Kirkland's a little large. But other than that, I think they look pretty good.
And I feel like, go ahead, Robert.
No, I was going to say, I thought the same thing. And if I had them, I'd probably like strip the paint color out of them so that it was just look raw,
I didn't think about doing that, but you probably could. And they they probably could have came up with a little like fancier design, just maybe like a KS somewhere on. They're small, but you could actually chip it out of there. That would look pretty cool, I think.
But so when you set up and you're looking down them, is it thick? Are they thicker? Or are they thin?
The top line.
It's kind of right in between. I mean, I feel like it's pretty similar about thickness to my Titleist. So like looking down, I put both seven irons like down next to each other today, and like it didn't feel awkward. Or like sometimes you just look over a club and like the older Callaways, I would see those things and be like, this looks like one of those like plastic golf clubs that, like, yeah, Bam Bam had in like Flintstones. But no, these look like very, very clean. They do look sharp. I mean, I was kind of impressed.
Can we make a deal that if you end up gaming those, you have to send those away, and maybe the CGT will pay for half of it, but you have to send them away. We got our guy at Wedge FX.
Okay.
And you need to get lasered rotisserie chickens on each iron.
Sure. Hey, if you guys are paying, I'm like down for whatever. Robert said I had a budget for these golf clubs, so I got to put in my receipts, I guess, but
your expense report.
Yeah, why not? We'll put a hot dog on some and rotisserie chickens.
It's a write off. It's a write off. But no, that it would be super interesting if you ended up gaming those. That would be wild. But hey, I guess it depends on the numbers and the feel and stuff like that. Like, do you think you would get to a point, like, if you were hitting those well, like, would it be an ego thing to get past, or would you be like, if I'm playing well, I'm playing well?
No, I mean, I use a mini driver all the time, and people are like, oh, you're like hitting the ball real well, why don't you hit a driver? I'm like, it is a driver, pal. Like, when you get back to finding your ball, like, deep in the woods, we'll talk about it a little bit more. But it's not an ego. I mean, like, I played the Kirkland ball for like a little while, and I would just, no, it's not going to spin. So I'm going to hit the ball a little bit shorter and let it kind of like run up to the hole a little bit. But I mean, I'm 43 year old, married with children. Like, I don't have an ego about stuff, like, whatever.
I mean, that's what, if you shoot, if you break 80, who gives a shit?
Right.
Like,
and it's just,
if you're that concerned about the logo, like I said, you can take it off. I mean,
right,
take out the paint. You can paint something different. You're going to extend them. You're going to put the grips on them that you want. It doesn't matter,
When I had the Costco putter at that, where do we play? I think it was Seven Bridges in that tournament. About four or five people just stopped and asked me, like, how do you like that? How do you like that? How do you like that? Just, seeing something new like that. And same thing. Like, I thought that putter was very well made. It felt good. So for me, and just, I feel like for most golfers out there, like, they shouldn't have that much of an ego with it. Just that clubs are so expensive, and you want to get new people like into the game of golf, and like, oh, now you got to spend like $5,000 like a whole bag, or you could get something like this, or like used clubs is a really good way of going, like, when you're new. But I mean, we'll see. We'll compare them to my irons I have now and go from there, I guess.
Well, I mean, I think it's the great model. I mean, that's why sub 70 is so successful too, just because, direct consumer, keeping the cost down, keeping the interest there. So
I just didn't know if you would have a problem like rolling up to the first hole having the Kirkland irons out and about, and potentially, allegedly, maybe getting some heat for that, or you just don't give a shit.
I don't care. You know, yeah. it really wouldn't bother me. I mean, hopefully I'm like playing well. And I like, if I hit it and, you know, it just doesn't feel a good swing, I'll probably just bundle them up and sell them, or, you know, try to convince Robert to buy them for some reason, Nolan or something like that. But yeah. if it goes well, I would definitely keep them and hit them. And, you know, as good of a ball striker I am, like, I feel like I'm going to hit these clubs really, really well here. Maybe Costco will just sponsor the whole podcast here. But I do see what you're saying. There are some people that are just, you know, got to have like the name brand for everything, yeah, or, you know, that label like makes a difference. And you guys are probably seeing it as well. Like, if they would just spend a portion of that money, like taking some lessons, like learning, sure, how to swing a golf club, then like.
Well, I got a kick out of a lot of the guys on Twitter saying they're just going to put the lead tape over the logo.
I didn't see that. Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
That's a good look too, you know?
Right. Right. Well, it's unfortunate you haven't hit those yet, because you can't necessarily buy them this week for the buy or sell. I'm interested to see, you know, in the next week or two when we do the buy or sell, if that comes up. I'm sure it will. But let's jump right in to the buy or sell segment. Boys, what did we like this week? What didn't we like? Big Rob, are we buying or are we selling?
We're buying this week. I haven't been able to sleep a lot the last week. So, you know what? I've bought into old seasons of Big Break. And I'm, man, I forget how good that show was. I'm so disappointed they haven't brought it back. It's just, and to see some of the people that played in it, like the Bryan brothers and
Tommy
stuff like that.
Tommy Two Gloves.
Mm-hmm. Tommy Two Gloves. Yep. Like, it's such a great show. So I've made me fall in love with it all over again. I got excited when I've been through like two seasons already. So that's what I'm buying this week.
Very nice. Vince, how about you?
I am buying, and just watching the golf over the weekend, I like the different formats within a golf tournament. So on Sunday, both players hit their tee ball, and then the men and the women, they switched and then hit each other's ball going for the rest of the hole. I know with our Pawpaw Cup, you know, we've done, you know, different things like that. We've played a Texas scramble or a modified Texas scramble, something like that. And I like alternate shot. A lot of people are just like, oh, you can't do alternate shot, that's too hard and everything. We do a modified for that. We will each hit our tee ball, and then we'll pick whichever one is the best, and then alternate shot from there. Actually, you know, the scramble kind of gets boring. I don't say boring, but like, it's the same thing over and over again. Like, why not mix it up a little bit? So I like that they did that at the tournament.
Very nice. I am selling this week. And I'm selling threads. I don't know if you guys have been on it yet, but supposedly it's supposed to be like the new golf Twitter space, because apparently golf Twitter is dying. And I've even said it, it is dying. Golf Twitter, like normal golf Twitter, like, and maybe this is just my followers, but it's the same guys talking about the same courses, talking about the same, you know, score they shot. It gets a little old. But threads is supposed to be like this new version of golf Twitter, and I don't quite understand it. I can't get, for the life of me, I can't generate any type of engagement at all.
Downloaded it, but I am yet to even like open the app.
Yeah, it's a little odd. I don't know. I don't know. Not many people are on it. I mean, there's a few, you know, the like your followers from Twitter kind of transfer over, but like, mm-hmm, nobody's really on it, and it's kind of weird to me. But anyways, I've been on it for like the last month and a half, 2 months, and I've got nothing. I don't know what's going on. I've stopped posting 9 after 9s to it. I'm sticking to IG and TikTok for that. I don't even do it on Twitter anymore, just because, again, like the old heads, they don't, for whatever reason, I don't know if they don't like it or what, but it gets zero traction, which is bananas to me. But anyhow, I'm selling threats. So I'm sorry we didn't get a clean sweep of buys this week, but I had to get that out there.
It's okay. As long as you didn't do the one that you sent me earlier this week, I'm happy.
What was that?
With the cats.
Oh, Miss Corda. Miss Corda. Yes. I, to be honest, I forgot about that. Vince, do you know anything about this?
I do not. I mean, I learned about that girl last week, and we were at a basketball game Tuesday, and there was a little girl in front of us, and she was watching that girl with the pink shirt and the blue suspenders or whatever it is. And I was like, I know that girl.
Well, we know about Big Rob's infatuation with Nelly Korda, correct?
Mm-hmm.
He loves her. Anyways, I saw this thing on IG, and it was her like taking her cover off her bed, and there was like 30 kittens in her bed, and I almost puked because I'm not a cat guy.
I can't stand cats.
I don't want to discriminate here, but I think
would be pissed.
I think they're freaks. I think they usually smell like piss, and it's not good. A lot of mustiness coming out of cat ladies. Anyways, it rubbed me the wrong way because I loved Nelly so much going into that. I had a small crush on her and I saw that. And then my dog lover came out and I sent it to Rob and I said, I might sell Nelly Korda this week. Just from this video.
My brother-in-law Shane would not be happy with you, man. He's a huge cat. Huge cat guy.
That explains a lot now.
Yes, 1,000%. Yeah, I'm allergic to cats, so that's where it stems from. But as we go down the rabbit hole, I'm just a dog guy, and you'll learn more about that in my top three. And we're gonna jump right into the top three.
Ooh.
Vince, because we didn't think it's actually Rob's turn, but Rob did the old Undertaker last minute, so we skipped him and we're going to Vince. Vince, what's your top three this week?
So I want to know, like, I'm not really sick at all a lot. I've never taken a sick day for being sick. I'll just like drag myself into work.
First off, you have a hidden motive with that. You don't take a sick day so you can retire early. So don't give
this
me
guy,
that crap.
This guy doesn't get sick. He's asleep by 8:30 PM. We must have got this guy like out of the 50s.
You know, it takes me so much more work to get ready to have someone else teach what I do. I'm just better off going in like half steam and I'll just like get something in me and like I'll charge through. But here's my top three. When you are not feeling well, what are the top three things you need when you're sick?
I like this one.
I'll start this one.
All right.
Yeah. Three would have to be, you know, some type of Gatorade, you know, body armor type deal. Need those. That's a must. Two would probably be some good soup, some hearty soup. And then one's like, it goes hand in hand, a nice, you know, big comfy weighted blanket and some good TV to watch.
I love that. And it just reminded me of my buy. I had a buy this week and it just reminded me I'll keep it for next week. Anyways, all very good. I think we're all going to have very, very much the same kind of list here. My three hole will be fluids. Again, just like Rob, you got to have fluids when you're sick. Whether that's, you know, when we were little, that was like the only time we ever had Sprite. Like it was
exactly.
Cool. It was cool to be sick because you got Sprite or something.
Wait, do you remember? Yeah. Do you remember when you were a kid that your mom would put the sheet on the couch?
Yeah.
So that you'd sleep on the couch?
Yeah.
I missed that. Go ahead. Sorry.
In the old, not even a garbage can. It was usually like the soft the soup pot for you to throw up in.
The puke bowl.
Yeah,
the puke bowl.
The puke pot that we would use in 3 days for pot roast.
Or for fruit salad.
Yeah. Something insane. But yeah, three hole would be fluids. I might even just, because we're going to have the same list, I might just split it between like fluids and soup if that's doable. Or I could have soup in the two hole. That's fine too. And then I would say number one for sure is rest. If you're not resting when you're sick, you're just going to get sicker. Like you got to shut it down. You got to get fluids. You got to pump yourself full of fluids, meds, and you just got to shut it down. You can't be one of those guys who just stays awake the whole time. and tries to pound out as many Saved by the Bell episodes as possible. You got to shut it down. You got to get rest. You got to sleep. You got to get, you know, you got to recharge the old batteries. And going back to Miss Corda, my honorable mention is Teddy, my dog. I want my dog near me. I want somebody who doesn't talk, but who likes to sit there and hang out and likes to get pet, shows affection. And he's like a big hot stone in the bed too. So it's good for the old heart when you're sick.
You know, that I would agree with the dog. And when I say, you know, Robert's kind of sick, he's not going to make it on there. You're talking about, you know, people that don't talk back and those things. My wife asked if, you know, we wanted her to come on and then be the third person on here with all the podcasts and things that she listens to. I was like, no, we don't need your opinions here on this. But here's my top three. So usually if I do like not feel super well, it's usually like in the late afternoon. So I'll come home, I'll take a warm shower. I got the chills a little bit, take a warm shower, and I get a fresh pair of like sweatpants and sweatshirts. No like t-shirt, no underwear, just put that on, you feel comfortable. And then I'll get our big brown blanket. It's just a huge soft blanket. It'll kind of cover you the whole way. And I am with all of you guys. And Tom, you probably know the old chicken soup game for Joe Montana. I'll go with a little bit of, you know, chicken soup, some ramen right here, and just
he's got it in his cup.
Oh, he's eating that ramen. Man, that's good. And I do keep some ramen at like school. So once in a while, like I said before, I'll just put into a tumbler like this and I'll drink the broth a little bit and then take the noodles afterwards.
Unbelievable. I mean, this guy, you should go into marketing and just like, you know, be a affiliate marketer for some company that, I mean, this guy just pulls out a tumbler of ramen.
The props he had ready for today. It's great radio.
Right. Great radio. What was that? So wait, that was your one?
The one was the soup, just the warm liquid. But I tell you what, if no one mentioned this, if you don't feel well, like you take that hot shower, get dried and put on like those soft, fresh sweat suits and like sweatpants kind of makes you feel comfortable.
I mean, that's a great honorable mention. The shower is great. And the kids always giving me a hard time when they're sick. I'm like, go take a shower. You'll feel so much better. You'll feel clean.
Yep.
And as soon as they get out of the shower, they hate it. But when they get out, they're happy about it.
Well, there's a lot of benefits. The steam will break up a lot of the mucus in your
chest. Oh, yeah.
And just to your point, and same with, you know, maybe this doesn't even correlate, but same with like being hungover. There's people that like physically won't get out of their bed when they're hungover. And it's like, dude, if you go brush your teeth and hop in the shower, you're guaranteed to feel like 70% better.
Yeah, feel better.
If you just do those two things. And then if you get some Gatorade electrolytes in you, then you're up to like 80. Then you might just hop back right on the bus and then you're back to 100.
Right.
Shit, when we were kids, like my mom would make us go in the bath or put the towel over our head.
That's what I was going to say.
And let the hot water run in the just out of the faucet in the bathtub, and she made you just sit there for like 20 minutes to get that all in. I mean, these kids these days, they don't even
know. I used to love that. Like my dad would always say, you know, just go in there and get the steam on you. Yep. Or I like putting some Vicks. Like if you have like a runny nose, like a stuffed nose, put like Vicks on your like nose here. And I'm actually kind of like semi addicted to it. If I'm like, you know, the kids like have a little something, or if they're coughing and you put it on the bottom of their feet,
I knew it.
But then I'll just take a little scoop of Vicks and put it on my nose there and just smell it in. I love the smell of Vicks.
When I was literally about to say, if Vince was ever sick, how I picture this going is like this old school like nomad with like onions in his socks, Vicks like all over his chest, you know, probably spiked in his hair, like just absolutely absurd. Probably like
he's in there right now.
Yeah, he's probably got a, you know, one of those book bags filled not with water, but like chicken bone broth that he's slurping through his, you know, through his hand.
Oh, a camelback?
Yeah, the camelbacks. Yeah, just unbelievable. And he's still eating his soup here. Speaking of unbelievable, great episode. Great episode. Rob, we wish you well. We hope you get well, you know, before the holidays. Obviously, that's a big thing. Yep. Speaking of next week, we're still TBD. We could potentially all be together. And that might be in the garage. That might be at Misswood or Cog. To be determined. So it could be a fabulous episode next week. But until then, we'll see you in the fairway.
See you in the fairway, boys.
See you, boys, in the fairway.